All right, so let's look at transformations, quadratic functions. We're going to talk about vertical dilations now. We've talked about translations, which is where you move a rigid parabola either up and down or to the left and right, depending on whether or not it's a vertical or a horizontal translation. So now we're going to talk about dilations, where we're actually kind of changing the shape of the parabola a little. It's still going to look like a parabola, but it's either going to appear to be more, you know, shallow or more open. It's going to open up a lot more quickly, or it's going to open up a lot more slowly. So it'll look wider or more narrow, if you want to think about it that way. And the way these look numerically is we have this f of x equals x squared. That's our parent function, right? And then we're going to be changing that by multiplying that by something. And so we're going to look kind of at what happens when we change that number in front of the x squared terms, all right? And that's always that you're not going to ever see any parentheses in these, at least not with where that a number is, where you're changing it. So let's take a look at, let's go to decimals. And I think this will make a lot more sense if we just do this visually. So I got y equals x squared. That's my parent function, right? And if you look at that, you know, if you put one in, all right, this is going up kind of slowly. So let's make this so they're ones, all right? So if you put one in, you get the 0.1. If you put two in, you get 2.4. You put three in, you get 9. You put four in, you get 16. So the rule is, you know, it's just squaring that number. Now, what happens, you know, and then it's symmetric over the y-axis. So what happens if I take this and I decide that I'm going to multiply that, I'm going to keep everything the same except I'm going to make this y equals 1 half x squared. Well, if you look at this, what's happening is the blue one, which represents our transformation, our dilation, it's opening up a little more slowly. And if I continue to change that number and make this number in front of it smaller and smaller and closer to zero, this basically is going to look like it's almost flattening out a little bit. All right, and so they have some language they use for this, and they call it compressed or stretched. All right, so let's look at this, and we're talking about it vertically. So if we're talking about it vertically, we're talking about in relation to how much does it vertically change compared to the parent function. So if we look at the point where x equals 2, in my original function, my y value was 4. Now, in my changed function, my transformed function, my y value is now 2. It is smaller. So if you think about compressed or stretched, stretch would probably imply that it's bigger. Compressed would imply that it's squeezed or it gets smaller, which is kind of like what compression is, right? So we would call this a vertical compression. We would say it is compressed vertically. Okay, so that's kind of what it looks like when you talk about compressed. Is for me, that's a little counterintuitive because I think, oh, well, it looks like it's stretching out, but I'm thinking about it in terms of horizontally, not vertically. In terms of vertically, like how far up it goes for each value, the original parent function is higher than the new one, and it's always higher by a factor of 2. All right, and so we would say that our g of x, or our altered function, is compressed vertically. So let's look at what happens if I take this now. All right, I'm going to change this. I'm going to make this a 2. All right, so now we have the opposite thing going on. This thing is opening up a lot faster, and it's moving up a lot quicker, which if you think about it, if you multiply something by 2, it makes it bigger. Right, so that makes sense. So it's making my y value bigger for every x value. You put one in, you know, for x, like right here, you get 1. Well, if you put one in here, you're gonna get 2. Over here, when you get to 2, the value is 4, so the new value is going to be 8. And so when we look at this again in the same context of what we were looking at before, whether or not it's stretched or compressed. Well, let's look at x equals 2. My original value for x equals 2 is y equals 4. All right, that's this point right here if I hit it. But then when I look at this one right here, when x equals 2, my y value equals 8. So it's like we took this and we stretched it up. It is bigger now. So we would say that this is stretched vertically when we're talking about a dilation. So pretty much when you look at your vertical dilations, you won't have really any parentheses, for at least not in these first sets of problems you're doing, where that's going to change that. And you just got to kind of know the distinction between whether it's compressed or stretched. And it's just more talking points than anything. All right. And we're going to look at horizontal ones next in the next video. And I think you're going to see that even though they kind of look the same, they are different. All right. Thanks.